here we are with our amazing Visual Studio code. Let me see, I don't know whether I have put subrime in here. Combinator selectors, that will be our focus. HTML and CSS, but this one here would be okay. We can use this, doesn't have much in it. Is working in the background. I think that is why I'm having this bit of a hiccup. Okay, so this would be what your page would look like, and my title is going to be the first page. I can have a title called Combinator or just Selectors. Have a title of Selectors, then we could have an H1 here, maybe that says Combinator Selectors. And save, and maybe open in the browser. We can also look at our index.css. Okay, and then we find that we are okay and good to go. So in case at any point you are not hearing me, text me on WhatsApp, because I am recording this tutorial such that you can be able to review it after we are done. You can just have it for keeps, or use it for practice. So in the other document on my site, we were saying that combinator selectors are a type of selectors that combine other elements in a way that gives them a useful relationship to each and to each other and the location of the content in the document. That might be very wrong, but we can choose to talk about what we could be experiencing, and one of the things we can talk about under combinator selectors is that they are different selectors. One is a descendant selector, and we can say that the descendant selector, we can come here, maybe what should we do, we can say H3 here, hit enter, it opens and closes for me. Then I say descendant selector, and this, when you say descendant selector, this is, you can go ahead and say this is represented by a space, space character, for the character, we are going to see why. The when we call them combinator selectors, this means that they are going to combine more than one selector to achieve their purpose. So majorly that is why they are called combinator selectors. They combine more than one selector to achieve their purpose. So I can style this H3. By this we are using simple selectors or element selectors, which was the first lecture. You can say background is maybe, okay, see green. We could say that the color is the white smoke. Color is white smoke. We could say that we want the width to be about 300 pixels. Then we can say that the border dash radius can be about 5 pixels. This helps us to create round curvature. Can put a comment here. By saying, let's say this, and then this would give us a comment. So we can say this creates curves or round edges. And then we save. We need to pull this out because the space we have defined is small, and we can just make it a paragraph here. I put it here that this is represented by a space character. We shall see how to go about that. But when we refresh our page now, this is what we are able to see, the send and selector. We gave it the same background, that is why it looks like that. We can just kick this out. Can keep that out, and then we shall, when we refresh, we have something like this. Slightly we can change this to, can say text dash line. Your next lecture will be on text. The next three links I'm going to send you after this lecture are going to be about text, so you will meet stuff like text dash align. Center. I'm used to Linux operating system or Ubuntu, that is why I use those cards. I forget and use the shortcuts on Windows, yet they can't work. So I can refresh this one and it is now centered. So let's begin. We could come here to HTML and talk about the send and selector. And in that equation, we say that under descend and selectors, we can say that this is represented by a space character and combines two selectors. That is why we call them combinator selectors, such that elements matched by the second selector are selected if they have an ancestor element matching the first selector. I will explain when we do the code. That's when you can remember it properly. So we can say div, it closes, then I can say class. The class here I can use say foot. And in here we can say paragraph. And we say I like any type of meat, and then we can say section. We can say section. Close this. We can say section paragraph, and we say fried. Or not, I just eat. Paragraph is closed, but we need to close the section tag. We could have another paragraph in this div. that phase literally, or types of meat. That is when you agree that you are a meat person. So when I refresh my page down here, we shall have these like this. So now we are going to test what combinator selectors are. You look at this. This is a class. This is an element. One is a class, another one is an element, and that means that when we combine them, we create what we call combinator selector. So when we set dot foo p like this, then we open our brackets, not correct, p, then we can open our brackets like that. Food dot food class becomes the parent. At that point, dot food class becomes the parent, and p becomes the child. So whatever is in this p section, section p, p are called children of the class food. So when we say that it combines two selectors such that the elements matched by the second selector, this is the second selector. So I say that the elements matched by the second selector are selected. By saying selected, it means the contents, the properties and property values we are going to put here are then applied. That is what we mean by selected. So once again, we are saying combine with two selectors such that elements matched by the second selector are selected if they have an ancestor element. Now, this is the parent and it is also the ancestor. If they have an ancestor element matching the first selector, what does that mean? This is the first element, but if we simply had a mishap here, like this, if we called it food and then p, yes, we might find that in foods, we might find that p is existing as a second selector, yes. But if we have a wrong class like foods here, yet we have only food, then p will not be selected. These will not be selected. That is what we are trying to do, to mean that this must also match and this must also match, and then the elements in here can therefore be selected. So we can take it back to food. Yes? Something small, we can say that the color is maybe white. We could say that the background can be maybe dark blue. What else? We can slightly increase their font size. You are going to see these in the coming tutorials. Font size, you will meet it there. So this can be 20 pixels. So when we refresh our page, here, all are selected. Why are they selected? Because they all match. Let me show you. They are all selected because we have P in this class. It does not segregate whether this begins by section, but wherever there is a P in that class, it will be selected, and therefore, whatever we have decided, all the properties and property values we have used the other side, will take effect So, but you can see, because we said food dot foods p rather dot food p, we can put here foods and we save. Then we go back and refresh our page, and now nothing is selected. Why is nothing selected? Because whereas p is correct, its ancestor is not foods. See, whereas p is a correct element and it exists in our HTML, this dot foods, the class called dot foods, doesn't exist. So if it doesn't exist, then these properties will not be selected or applied until, because when we check on our HTML, we have a class called food. If we change this to foods, for example, and save, then they will match. When we refresh, we shall get the same result. So, the next element we can look at, the next combinator we can look at, we can just copy this H3. The beauty with the CSS file is that it will keep on making the designs for you, once applying the designs for you. Once you design it the first time, you don't need to, as long as it is the same element, you don't need to design it again unless you are changing something. So another one is called child combinator selector. We can put here HR. HR here, we can put DR, and then we save, so this will go down and with a space. So child selectors, what are they? We can say paragraph, we can say that these are represented by, a greater than sign, and that greater than sign is placed between the two selectors that you are going to use. So when we are talking about combinator selector, we rest assured that we are talking about more than one selector. So what is the condition here? We can say, we can put it as a comment. We can say that this only works on elements. This only works on elements matched by the second selector that are children or child, because it could be one, that are children of elements matched by the first selector. So this is a lot of English. When we do it practically, that is when you cannot see, and that is what we are going to do. We can pick the same example here, we copy, paste it down here, change it to food, such that it does not become affected by any of what we are going to do here. So when we refresh our page, first and foremost, we shall see something like this. Because we had selected H3, it will keep on, anywhere we put H3, it will keep on giving us these. How do you reduce the length of these lines? By applying width. Like I said, I keep thinking I'm using the Linux operating system and these shortcuts. So I can come here and say width, for example, if that becomes too huge and dirty, I can say width 400 pixels. When I refresh my page, I expect the blue to reduce toward the left, and this is what I have. So width is meant for affecting how wide this is going to be. And by default, because these are what we call in my document called what is. In my document called what is HTML, I slightly talk about block level elements and inline elements, but we are going to expand them when we come to text. The next links I'm going to send you, if I send them today, is the Thursday, but let me see, they will be around 5. I expect that the next week on Thursday, you will have finished them, God willing, such that we can move at a constant pace, that each week we can handle a topic. There are those that can span to a second week, depending on the challenges you could be having, which is also okay. Okay. So, let us dive into this child selector thing. Now, we have created a class called foods. You can copy this. Okay. We change this to foods. But we said, okay, we can even put a comment here for us to remember. We call this child selector. Then this was descendant. So descendant selector. This is important because if you have a very huge program, you spend like a year minus touching it, they bring it back, you don't remember what you did. But when you have comments, they can easily tell you that here you were trying to achieve this, and on this occasion you were trying to achieve that. Even though the code looks the same, but it could have been achieving something else. So, child selector. We said when we get back here, we said that this only works on elements matched by the second selector. In this case, P will be the second selector, that are children. I need to emphasize the word that are direct. That's the difference. This word will mean all the difference. That are direct, so the children must be direct. And I will show you what it means by being direct. And we also say that it uses represented by a greater than sign. So here, remember we had said that the descendant selector is represented by space. This is the space in between them. And we are saying that this one here is represented by a greater than sign, like this. So once you use a greater than sign, you are telling CSS or the web browser that is going to display your information that what you are dealing with, you are saying that only apply these if P is a direct child of this class. If P is a direct child of this class, these properties will be applied. Now, let us test that. Those properties will be applied. You can refresh our page here. You can refresh our page. And now you see they were three, but only two are selected. Let us go back and I show you why. Why are they selected? We are talking about direct children or direct child. P is a direct child. What do you mean by direct? That from foods you can go to P. From foods you can go to this P. But from foods you cannot go to this. You see? You cannot go to that P. Why? You have to pass through section. So this P is a child, is a direct child of section. Whereas section is a direct child of foods. So, but now that we are saying foods, then the greater than sign and P, we cannot select section. Whereas the first one was selecting everything as long as they were children, everything would be selected. But now this one here is special, that it will only pick the direct children. Now, if I say the section, for example, I expect that only one paragraph will be selected, this one here in the middle. You can see why, because it is the direct section, is the direct child of the class called foods. I hope that is clear. Let me take it back to P, like this. So the next one, the second last one, is what we call sibling combinator. Adjacent sibling combinator selector, we can have it here, H3. Hit enter, this is adjacent sibling, sibling combinator selector, adjacent sibling combinator selector. So what can we talk about this? We can say, like we have been saying, we've been looking at them before, we can say that this is represented by a plus sign, the normal plus sign of a cross, and it is placed between two selectors. Okay, we can say another paragraph to explain further. We can say that this selects, this selects elements that are right, that are right cross each other. We are going to explain this right cross each other. Right cross each other. You can also say either the ones before or after, depending on the arrangement of selectors. Now let us get into an example and you see what will happen. We are going to use just the same example. Let me first put, you can copy these ones here. I put them here such that you have some space there. Then I can just use the same example here. Now the other one was foods. Maybe we can call, let's say, goods. Let us call it, okay, let us begin with good. Can call that good. So we are saying that good and P, for example, in between there must be a plus sign. Okay, that is what we are going to look at, and we see what that means. We can say, for example, I want you to see the arrangement. Let me go back here, refresh my page. This is what I have: adjacent siblings, blah blah blah, these are our notes, and then this is our information. Okay, we almost finished the whole line. So we can say dot good. Here we call this adjacent sibling selector. Okay, or combinator selector, at the preferable one. Once we finish this selector, the rest of the links that you are going to go through might not be confusing like some of these, but they are more advanced. We are going to keep on advancing. We are not going back to cheap stuff, much as once in a while cheap stuff is going to pop in, but it will pop in when the topic is starting. As you get into deeper into the topic, then you will see that this is getting exciting. So you can, here we say that this selects elements that are right close to each other, and there must be a plus sign in between those elements. We are also saying that it depends on how you arrange the elements at the time of selection. So let us copy this once again. Copy here. then we can set P plus section. Now, before I refresh once again, I want us to look at the positions of this thing. This is P, as you can see here. This is section, as you can see here, and this is also P. So when we refresh the page, we had said P plus section. When we refresh the page, you can see that it is section that was selected, right close to each other. So we say if you wanted to select this alone without using child selector, you could use adjacent sibling and say P plus section, and you'd select this, because we had seen how to select this by simply saying dot foods greater than sign section. It could also pick this only, but there is another way we can do that, by saying P plus section. Now, if we change the arrangement like this, section space plus P, so it means P is going to be selected. But remember, we have two P's, we have this and this. So when we refresh our page, we shall realize that the downer one will be selected. We come back to my point here. We are saying this selects elements that are right. So preferably, it is going to pick the right hand side. It will pick the elements to the right. So when you say section plus P, it will pick the P that is to the right of section. Now, let us put some cover a little bit. But if we came in here and said H4, okay, because you might ask yourself, but if it is not adjacent, what will it do? When we put in H4 here, and we are saying, we can say just trying to test our code. Remember, the function here, or the selection here, is saying section plus P. So, and it is saying adjacent sibling selector, meaning it must be close to section for it to be selected. But now, close to section is H4, not P. So what we need to do? Let us refresh and find out. When we refresh, here we are. Nothing takes place apart from just inserting our H4, but nothing is selected. Why? Because P is not the one next to H4, rather next to section. This is section, this is H4, here this is P. So if we want to select this P, then we have to remove section here, okay, and put H4. So that way P is close to H4, and it means then that we can select P like this. If you wanted to select H4, then we can put H4 here and then put section here. Why? Because in our HTML code here, section is close to P, rather to H4. That means it H4 will be selected if we use this function in CSS. When we refresh, we expect this to be selected. We refresh, and yes, it is selected. So that is the adjacent sibling combinator, and the last one will be general sibling combinator. Let us look at it. General sibling combinator. Right now, you might wonder, where am I going to apply these? But just shortly after, you will start applying them. This is the most common one. This one here is the most common one. And just selecting by class alone is also next to that. But we shall come to this when we come to complex stuff. Like when you are dealing with the nested lists, we shall come to lists and links later. I want us to begin with text. When you finish text, you understand what margin padding and widths are, then you understand positioning. After positioning, then we can before positioning, you have understood borders, which you are going to do before text. The borders, then text. After that, then you understand positioning, how you can position an item anywhere on this screen, anywhere. By anywhere, I mean anywhere. You can position it right here, the way this one is. We shall cover that. After that, then we shall see how to go back to lists and links. When we come to lists and links, then we shall create navigation bars, and your website will now start to look clean. What are navigation bars? You can just come here and say maybe UCU. You can say UCU and hit enter. And so we shall cover those in that sequence, and they keep on advancing, like I say. Much as when you are introducing a topic, some might look easier than others, but that's how it is. No problem with it. So this is the UCU website. By the time we finish links and lists, where we shall look at navigation bars, you will have learned how to do this. Apart from this sliding image, because you cover it under images, but how to position this, you have learned it. How to position this, you have learned it. How to add icons here, you have learned it. How to add these icons, you have learned it. How to create such drop down menus, you will have learned it from links and lists. So you will be able to now start looking at stuff and you say, okay, you will even learn how to position like this. This is CSS positioning, this one here. This is a tooltip. I will show you, like I told you, we shall cover tooltips, and I will show you how to create such a tooltip. But it is also a tooltip. This is CSS positioning, this is an icon. So I want you to concentrate really and enjoy, because it is going to be enjoyable. So let us look at our last example, which is general sibling combinator selector. You can come here and copy these, okay, paste here, then we change this to general sibling. General sibling combinator selector. We can refresh our page here, and we shall find it there, general sibling combinator selector. So what are we looking at? Paragraph, we can say that this is represented by this symbol. I don't know how you call it. I've forgotten the mathematical name for this. This is represented by that symbol, which is usually found at the button below escape and above tab. So it is between escape and tab button, and you activate that by pressing shift and then that symbol. So it is the first character on most of the keyboards that have 1, 2, 3, 8, rather 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 0 as their keys in that order, which is the second line. So it is the first button on the second line of your keyboard. most people find challenges with that. That is why I'm referring to explain. So it is represented by that, and we are saying that this select siblings, this select sibling of elements that are both direct or indirect to a particular element. We can see what this means practically, and that will help us a lot. We can say so we are saying that this select siblings that are both direct or indirect, meaning they don't have to be changed, or rather to be direct children for them to be selected, but we can use elements. Let us try both. You can pick here, copy, and paste here. You can change this to goods. Let us say that, for example, this one is general sibling. General sibling. Then we can say that. Can copy this first. Let's first use this. Let me pull it up a bit here. So we can say, let us begin by just saying or. But if we said, okay, let us just begin with this or, but we know H4 is just one in there. So when we refresh our page, down here is what we have. H4 is once again selected. It was just one, a single element. Then what if we instead said, we can do vice versa. For example, we can say H4, then all section. Again, section is just one element, but now we can use it to highlight backwards. Refresh and. Section, sorry, I can pick a PH4 and a P, and I save. I refresh my page, and now did we change this? Okay, speaking some of this, but it's okay. So it has H4, and also we have got. This is now selecting our H4, which we don't want, because it is going to confuse you. Let us put it out to confuse you when it remains like that. So here we are selecting this once again. But if we had a class, but if we said dot H4, the class was goods. I hope, let me check. Goods or P, and then we refresh our page. This is not selecting anything. Why? Because it picks on elements. They have to be elements, and that is why we are not picking anything here, even when we have our class matching. So we could put another element here, for example, that H1. Let us assume we have an H2 here. H2 that says okay. And then we use it to select here instead of the class. We can say H2. And then that P, when we refresh, our H2 will be here. And we didn't save this one. H2 will be there, and then I have something like this. So it picks both P's at the same time. You can see this is H2, this is H, sorry, this is H2, this is P, this is section, this is H, I think 4, and then this is H2, so it is picking both H2s at the same time, whereas the very first one, which was the descendant, was picking everything as long as it was children. The child selector was picking, it picked these two because they were direct children. Adjacent, we saw that it uses the plus sign, and if whatever element you choose, it will pick the next or whatever is closed it to the right hand side, and so on and so forth. So that is the all we had to do for today. If you have some questions, maybe you can put them on WhatsApp. Otherwise, I will now send you links of lecture 2, so we call it lecture 2, that is talking about text. Have a good evening.